Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I'm going to be talking about this new product that I found. This is the kicker Hideaway in a 10 inch, and man, I'll tell you, I really like the way this subwoofer sounds. It really gave the truck what it needed, and it's one of the main problems with this particular truck is it doesn't have much cabin space when it comes to hiding a sub. I'll show you guys where I put it. First of all, that's where my truck seats usually are. That's where I sit, and that's where I have the passenger one. As you can see, it's not underneath the front seats. I went and put it underneath the bench, but unfortunately with this particular bench, it's not hollow underneath. There's this plastic that really limits you, but it's not a problem. I got you guys a solution right here. It's already installed. I will play a demo for you. This model didn't come with the Bose sound system, and that wasn't too much of a deal breaker for me, but I do like, you know, having nice sound. The stock speakers sound great, but they don't have that punch that I wanted, and now it does. I've actually had both trucks. I've had the truck with the Bose sound system and the truck without. This, the way that I have it set up right now with the stock speakers plus this kicker 10 inch sounds better than the Bose when it comes to bass. 100%, you just have more punch. The Bose is really good, but this is your workaround if your truck didn't come with it. Let me try to pick up the seat real quick. There we go. For you guys who don't believe me, don't worry, I'll play some music for you right now. Alright, there's the kicker 10 inch. As you guys seen, the seats folded down just fine, nothing was in the way. Unfortunately, you cannot put two back here without making some modifications. If you did want to put two, it is pretty easy. All you have to do is hollow out some of the front right here, and that doesn't mess with anything over here. But as it sits right now, nothing needed to be done besides just hooking it up. I took it to Best Buy. They did it for, I think, $120 install only. That sub cost $369. So that's like, what, $400 or $500? But enough talk. Now let me, it's just gonna be the radio because I'm using my phone as a camera right now. And having the Bose was almost a deal breaker for me, to be quite honest, because I really liked the way the Bose sounded. Like I said, I've had the same exact truck in a different year. Let's see, Bluetooth. Whoa, yeah, that's Doja Cat. It also comes with the sub adjuster, so I can lower it. That's completely lowered. I'm gonna turn the volume up so you can hear the difference. Now I'm gonna turn the bass up. That's the max pitch. That song is trash. Wait for it.
Maybe that one. Good morning. Who's this?
Oh, wow.
Good morning. What in the?
Yeah. From San Bernardino. Who am I?
Who cares who you are? Jesus. Sorry. I always play Bluetooth.
Don't come. I'm a big man. You the only father that I ever know. I get my trade that I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made way back in
them, you do have to do some slight modifications, but like that, I mean, honestly, I have no need to. I really like the way it sounds. Because the subwoofer is not inside of a car trunk or in your bed, it's all inside of the cabin, so it sounds really good. It sounds really good. I've had multiple sound systems in my cars before. I didn't put it in my other Colorado because, like I said, it already came equipped with the Bose, and I didn't feel like it needed it. But this truck did. This truck needed it. It doesn't have a sub. It just has the factory speakers plus now this kicker, this 10-inch kicker. I'm really happy with the way it came out. Before, I would give the truck audio probably maybe a 6.5 out of 10. It's very clear, very loud, but it just didn't have that kick, and now it does. Now it has that little bit of bass that it needed, and I'm really happy. It's worth the $369. Keep in mind, you don't have to buy an amplifier. You don't have to have two separate things back there. It's just one item. It's very slim. And very happy with it. Even if you have the Bose sound system, trust me, you might want that little bit of extra punch. Now, I had to get this directly from kicker.com because I usually just shop at Best Buy when it comes to audio, but they do not carry the 10-inch, I believe. I believe they only have the 8-inch, and you know, just go with the 10. What are you gonna go for an 8 for if they have a 10? The 10 is actually the same size. They just put the bigger speaker in pretty much the same size box. Now when you're driving to work, you have the audio that you like. Let's see if they have the dimensions on here for you guys. Oh, there we go. Feel free to pause the video. These are going to be all of the specifications. So it looks like it's 10 inches wide, 12 inches long, or I'm sorry, 14 inches long. I'm sorry, I read that completely wrong. 8 inches wide, 14 inches long, and then it doesn't show the height is right there. Height is about 3 inches. Right? Yeah. And then here are the rest of your guys' goodies. The wattage. Then just the wires. They charged me $120 to install it and came out really good. Super happy. I don't see a need in upgrading these. They work just fine. If one of them pops or blows, then yeah, of course, I'm going to buy some new speakers for the doors. But as of right now, it sounds really good. It's working just fine. And I added what I wanted. Yep. I solved your guys' problems if you have a Colorado ZR2. Everybody, I'm sure, wanted that more bass. But they don't have room because of this whole contraption that they have going on right here. You can put it underneath the seat, but it sticks out about this much, okay? So this much of the sub is going to be showing. I usually don't have anyone in my backseat anyways. It's usually just me, unless I'm in the backseat, if you know what I mean. I'm just kidding. It can fit underneath your seat, but right there is pretty much the perfect place for me. I usually don't have anything right there anyways besides like gloves or screwdrivers, flashlights, and trust me, you still have a lot of room. You have all of this right here. You still have plenty of room underneath there. And 10 out of 10, that little Hideaway sub, it hits a lot harder than I was expecting. It hits very hard for being just a 10 inch little subwoofer. Don't need to do anything else. Yep. I'll see you guys in the next video.